Hello everyone, after promising this for quite a while now, I finally found some time to make this video, where I will show you how you can put a 13 cubic inch tank into a M16A2 buttstock onto your MCS-468. First of all, you need a reinforced M16A2 buttstock where I roughly mark the area where the tank should sit. When done, you can cut this area out with a hacksaw. For the horizontal cut, I was using an angle grinder with a thin blade. Now cut off the part that covers the front and keep it for later. When you place the bottle flush at the area you just cut out, you can roughly mark the area where the bottleneck is. And use the angle grinder again to cut out the horizontal line like I did it here. Do the same thing on the other side, and the bottle should sit like this inside of the buttstock. Also use a round file for the bottleneck area. On the front cover, mark the areas where the valve and the gauge is, so you can drill holes into it to make it fit onto the air tank like this. Be sure to be as exact as possible when measuring these holes, so the cover is sitting properly on the edge of the tank where the threads are starting. You can use files and sandpaper to remove rough edges and clean up the area you just cut out. To actually mount the tank to the buttstock, I was using 1mm sheet aluminium and flat aluminium blocks. The sheet aluminium, as well the flat aluminium, is roughly 20mm wide to accommodate enough space to drill in the holes you need to mount everything together. It actually doesn't matter what size of drills and threads you're using, as long as it works as intended. The holes go all the way through the material, as well the threads. Transfer the side face measurement of the blocks to the beginning of the sheet aluminium and bend it to 45 degrees. I was using round head hex screws to connect these two parts together. For bending the flat aluminium, you need to find a pipe or pole which is similar in diameter like your air tank. As you can see, I was screwing the aluminium block onto this pole in order to bend it in shape. Also make sure that the flat aluminium is long enough to go all around your air tank as well to mount on the aluminium block. Before I forget, depending where you cut out your buttstock, you might need to file out the front as well in order to make the gauge and the valve sit properly together with the top part. In order to fasten the tank, you need to drill holes into the bottom of the buttstock where the clamps are sitting at. Be careful to measure out these holes properly, because there is no going back when you drill them wrong. Here you can see how I mounted the clamps to my tank. On the bottleneck, I was using a smaller clamp, as you can see. I was using a spacer between the tank and the marker, so the bottle sits tight when screwing it in. The screws that leading from the bottom of the buttstock to the aluminium blocks on the inside are basically tightening the tank to the buttstock. If you did everything right, here is how I mount my buttstock to the marker. After placing the spacer on the backside of the ASA, I can screw in the tank. After screwing in the tank, make sure the clamps are rotated properly for the blocks to be below the tank. Now place the buttstock below your tank in order to mount it. To mount the tank to the buttstock, I was using a long countersunk screw for the backside and a short one for the front side. Don't tighten these screws too much to avoid damaging your buttstock. If the part that covers the regulator is loose, you can use some tape to secure it better to the buttstock. This is it. If you have any questions regarding this tutorial, feel free to comment down below, and I will try my best to help you.